There's no question that the economic upheaval caused by the pandemic has increased our business focus on spend management and budgetary control. Before the pandemic, about 3/4 of all businesses had a spend management program in place. This made perfect sense, right? We all want to be mindful of how it is that we're spending our money. But these programs have taken on a whole new level of importance during the pandemic. We know that COVID-19 has negatively impacted the revenues and profitability of many businesses and nonprofit organizations. In fact, many businesses ground to a halt as a result of government restrictions during the pandemic. Cash flow insolvency, well, it was a real threat for many businesses. And it still is, particularly for small and mid-sized ones that don't have the benefit of those large credit lines to draw down. So in response to all of this, well, businesses are reducing their spending. And let's face it, tightly controlled spending can help preserve our cash reserves. It can be an important first step in moving back toward profitability and strong revenues. 62% of all businesses have experienced lower revenues because of the pandemic. Many businesses are experiencing lower profits. Some of you are even facing cash flow disruption. And unfortunately, there's no telling when customer demand will rebound. So it's against this backdrop that 66% of businesses expect to reduce their spending for the balance of this year. We've already seen many businesses that have taken steps toward doing so, reducing staffing, cutting some costs, and peeling back on some of their investments. But when it comes to reining in spending, it's a tall order for many of us. Most businesses and nonprofit organizations, well, how do I say this gently? They were doing a pretty lousy job of managing their spending before the pandemic. In a survey from earlier this year, before the pandemic started, 74% of businesses and nonprofits admitted that their spend management needed work. And the disruption caused by COVID-19 isn't helping matters any. 1/4 of all businesses and nonprofits say that the pandemic has negatively impacted their organization's ability to manage its corporate spending. It's simply harder to chase down information about our spending and our budget compliance when people are working from home. Another 29% of businesses and nonprofits say they're not quite sure what impact COVID-19 has had on their spend management. Now, to me, this suggests that these people probably don't have strong visibility in the first place, and the problem is much bigger than many of us think. So the question becomes, just how bad a job are we doing at managing our spending? In a nutshell, really bad. Most businesses say they only have tight control over about 75% of all of their spending. Now, if I asked you if you'd be satisfied if 25% of the money your company spends was wasted or out of control, well, you'd probably think I was nuts. And yet, here we are. For many businesses, this is reality. It probably won't surprise you to learn that travel and entertainment expenses is an area where businesses believe they have the most work to do in spend management. This has been a point of pain for years. But when you look a little closer at this chart, the problem is even bigger. Spending on services and indirect materials, well, it's also a sieve in most businesses. And there's a lot of reasons for this. Like most things in finance, well, we can blame manual processes that most of us rely on for all the difficulties we have in managing our spend. While we've invested big money in state-of-the-art ERPs, for example, many of us still lean on spreadsheets for reporting. Yes, I said spreadsheets. Those relics of the 1980s that should have gone the way of parachute pants, Milli Vanilli, and ALF. What was ALF all about? So what are we doing here? Well, a lot of us are managing our spending in a completely manual fashion. with lots of manual data entry, lots of chasing down information, lots of paper shuffling, lots and lots of errors. Well, some of you are operating under the honor system, where the onus is on purchasers to ensure that they don't overrun a budget line item. Honest, I won't do it. Making matters worse, many of you have to manage large capital projects, amortization throughout the year, complicated encumbrance and commitment accounting. If this sounds like a recipe for disaster, you're right. In this type of environment, well, there's no way to enforce budget checking. Decision makers can't always be sure where things stand against budget. Reconciling reports is laborious, and all the keying and paper shuffling, well, it's expensive. It's error prone. And worst of all, there's no way to stop out of budget or rogue spending. In other words, one of the biggest reasons that spend management is so hard for so many of us is that we don't have strong control over our budgets. In fact, 46% of businesses have no unified real-time visibility into their enterprise spend. They're flying blind. And this is creating big, big problems for businesses and nonprofits at a time when we could least afford them. Today, many businesses and nonprofits have limited visibility into their procurement pipeline. They have difficulty reconciling reports. They miss expenditure forecasts. They have inaccurate employee expense reporting. And they have a whole lot of difficulty in meeting regulatory requirements. Well, clearly, investing in a world-class ERP, it's a good first step, but it's not enough to manage spending and control your budgets tightly. What businesses and nonprofits need is an automated way to do it, a way to tightly integrate budget control with that world-class ERP. And that's what a budgetary control solution does. It improves spend management in three important ways. First, it automatically checks budget availability prior to vendor obligation, so we don't have to try and put the genie back in the bottle. Second, it provides visibility into potential actuals in the procurement pipeline. We know exactly where we stand from the point that that vendor obligation is made. And third, delivers complete control and visibility across the business, not partial visibility, not visibility at the time that somebody saved that Excel spreadsheet a week and a half ago. No, it tells us where we stand right now as transactions are made and purchases are made. So if a budgetary control solution sounds compelling to you, well, you're not alone. More NetSuite customers are planning to deploy a budgetary control solution to achieve this granular visibility that they need in these trying times. It's what they believe is the solution for tightly managing their spending and controlling their budget. And that will be our final word. And thank you all for joining us and taking time out of your busy days to spend time with us. With that, on behalf of Piango, this is Mark Brousseau. Thank you all. Stay well, stay safe.